Greetings of the day to all my learners, all my students. Today I am going to explain a new topic termed as social learning theory. Social learning theory has been propounded by Albert Bandura. Okay, and I am Dr. Rashmi Singh, assistant professor in Department of Education in SS Khanna Girls Degree College. It is a constituent college of the University of Allahabad. So let's start. Social learning theory. The social learning theory, which put forth by Albert Bandura in 1977, is one such theory which is based on both cognitive and behavioral learning theories. This point has been specifically mentioned by me that it includes both elements of cognitive as well as behavioral learning theories. Then let's check what cognitive learning theories are. These type of theories are all about understanding how the human mind works while people learn. This means what is the role of mind, what is the role of thinking process, what is the role of brain activity in our learning. And behavioral learning theories are what? These types of theories focus on the idea that all behaviors are learned through interaction with the environment. Means behaviorism is based on this only fact, interaction with the environment. So social learning theory has combined the elements of cognitive as well as behavioral learning theories. The social learning theory goes a step further from what behavioral learning theories. What it suggests that internal psychological processes have also an influence on behavior. Means not only interaction with the environment, but our internal mental processes have also an influence on our behavior. Hence, it is termed that it is based on both cognitive and behavioral learning theories. Okay, then the main discovery of Bandura was that children learn aggression, violence and other such social behaviors through observational learning or observation learning. Okay, then Bobo doll experiment. Bandura has performed several experiments to prove his theory, and all these experiments are termed as Bobo doll experiment. The famous Bobo doll experiment proved that the children imitated the behavior. The children followed the behavior. The children observed such behavior what they saw and influenced. Means such behavior which has created some sort of influence over their mind, they tend to follow, they tend to imitate that behavior. For instance, the children influenced by the aggressive behavior subsequently behaved aggressively with the dolls. This is an example of the doll which has been used by Bandura in all his experiments, Bobo doll. The children who witnessed the passive and non-violence behavior subsequently interacted with the dolls in the same way. Means those children who have observed the aggressive behavior tend to follow the same behavior with the doll, and those children who witnessed the passive and non-violence behavior, they subsequently interacted with the doll in that passive way. This study has important implications for the effect of media violence on children. Means we have to have showcased non-violent activities on such platform like TV, YouTube and all the media, because children tend to follow such behavior. Okay, then concepts in social learning theory. This is termed as SLT also. The concept modeling, it is the most important concept. Okay, the concept modeling is an important finding of Bandura, which play pivotal role, because all his theory is circled around this only concept. In shaping one's behavior, attitude, beliefs and other emotional reactions, Bandura strongly advocated that learning mostly happened observationally through modeling. Means through modeling, through observation, most of the learning may mostly happen in social learning theory according to Bandura. Isn't it? He also argued that human behavior is the result of reciprocal interaction. Reciprocal interaction, two-way interaction between cognitive, behavioral and environmental influences each other. If cognitive is absent from here, then it becomes a simple behavioral learning theory. But it includes cognitive element also, so it termed as the combination of cognitive as well as behavioral learning theory. In general, the social learning theory justified the processes such as observation, imitation and modeling. Means first of all, we observe some behavior, then we try to imitate and then we modeled such behavior. Okay. So, these three processes play pivotal role in the acquisition of any knowledge or skills. In which theory? Social learning theory. Okay. Then the heart of social learning theory. While justifying that the observation, imitation and modeling, which we have discussed just earlier, help in the learning of new things, he added the other two factors. Means two remaining two factors which are equally important are known as attention and memory. Also help in the learning of new skills. Means five such terms. Observation, imitation, modeling, attention and memory helps in the social learning theory to imitate or to reproduce such type of behavior which we have seen, which has influence over us. There are three important concepts that are considered to be the axis of the learning as conceived by Bandura as follows. Means three important concepts, what are they? First one, one can learning through observation. It is clear, it is obvious from all such slides that one can learn through observation. Then, state of mind is important for learning. What does it mean? That one is ready to learn. This is equivalent to concept of readiness of learning to of Thorndike. Then, learning is also happened without permanent change in the behavior. Earlier we have learned that learning is permanent change in behavior. But Bandura had stated that learning may happen without permanent change in the behavior. Means he is talking about short-term learning. Then types of modeling. Bandura has performed various experiments and by the result of his experiments, he concluded that there are three types of models by which one can learn. What are these models? First one is a live model. This is an actual individual demonstrating a behavior, isn't it? This is clear from the term because it is live. So, a actual individual demonstrates a behavior. Then, verbal interpersonal model means here, no such individual is present. What is present here? It involves descriptions and explanations of a behavior only verbally. Okay, but it can also produce modeling. Then a symbolic model. What does it involve? It is real or fictional characters displaying behavior such as in books, films, television programs, etc. And these are also can create modeling in the individual. So, what are the three types of modeling? Live model, verbal interpersonal model and a symbolic model. Then, the most important part of the social learning theory, the components of observational learning. Sometimes social learning is also called as observational learning and most of the time there is a short notes. There is a question comes in exam that is discuss components of observational learning or describe process of observational learning. So, you have to write down these four processes. Two are here and two are in the next slide. First one is attention. Means the foremost component of observational learning is that we have to pay attention to the behavior which has been showcased, which has been seen to us. This is the component indicates the extent of the degree of notice paid and exposure gained through the stated modeled events and observer qualities. Isn't it? Then retention means, first of all, we have to pay attention. Then if we do not retain that behavior, then there is of no use. This phase of the observational learning emphasizes the amount of behavior remembered or retained through following stated components of observation. There are four important processes required for the component of observation, which are, means one has to retain any sort of behavior through these four processes. First one is symbolic coding, means one has formed code in the form of symbol. Then the process of mental activity comes in the terms of cognitive organization. Then we rehearse firstly symbolically and then motor rehearsal to retain any such type of behavior. Then the remaining two portions are reproduction and motivation. First one is attention, then retention, then reproduction, and then motivation. What does it reproduction means? This is the component of an observational learning meant for demonstration of the behavior seen and retained. But it is not possible in all cases of learning. It is clear that we cannot reproduce all such type of behavior which we are following. And last but not the least, there is motivation. Must, despite the prior stated components are important for the observation, this component sets the will to perform, the motive to perform the behavior out of vicarious and internal reinforcement. What is it? Vicarious reinforcement means it involves learning through observation of the consequences of actions for other people. Means if one is observing, if one is behaving, if one is performing in such a way that he or she gets reinforcement for that type of behavior, then we get vicarious reinforcement to perform, to model such type of behavior. Okay, then Bandura's self-efficacy. Actually, social learning theory is his main concept, but self-efficacy is also popularized by Bandura. This one is written here. Although Bandura is a key exponent of social learning theory, he also popularized the term self-efficacy because his theory considers that how one individual perceive himself or herself in the society and scale their own competencies of life. Self-efficacy means how one individual perceive himself or herself and as well as scaling his or her competencies of life also. He suggested the following two tasks from his social learning theory for the better performance. Means by these two tasks we can have better self-efficacy for ourselves. First one is the kind of action or the task that the learner chooses. Means which kind of action we are going to choose and the amount of consistent effort put into the task. Means how consistent we are in putting down our effort to accomplish that such task. Okay, then sources of self-efficacy. What are the sources of self-efficacy in an individual as stated by Bandura? As discussed already, in the components of observational learning, the performance accomplishment could be enhanced through the following sources of self-efficacy. What are these sources? First one is vicarious experience. It is the phenomena of observing another and feeling what they feel. Okay? Then verbal persuasion means verbally pursue someone for some task because it involves someone convincing another person that they have the capability to perform as task successfully. And last one is emotional arousal. It is simply at a state of heightened physiological activity. Okay, so by following sources of self-efficacy, we can enhance our accomplishment level. Then passages to develop self-efficacy. There are four passages provided by Bandura. First one is mastery experience, then social modeling, then social persuasion, and then states of physiology. It is somewhat equivalent to these states which have been discussed in this slide. You can also compare social modeling, social persuasion, states of physiology. States of physiology is like emotional arousal, social persuasion is somewhat similar to verbal persuasion, and Mastery experience and social modeling is somewhat equivalent to vicarious experience. Okay? Then, it is similar. Then, limitations of social learning theory. Means, social learning theory is a very important theory. It is very easily comprehensible theory, very easy and simple steps to follow, but there are certain limitations too. It does not give enough justification for how people develop a whole range of behavior, including their thoughts, such complex thoughts and feelings. Means only a limited range of behavior can be explained by social learning theory. The vast range of all our complex type of behavior cannot be explained by social learning theory. Okay? Because each time we do not only imitate others to behave in such a way, in a particular way. Then people have a lot of cognitive control over our behaviors. We are cognitive beings. We are cognitive. We have cognition. We don't reproduce the violent behavior just because observing them, because our conscience has also a control on our behavior. Hence, this point is also not being explained by social learning theory. And last but not the least, social learning theory is not a complete explanation for all our behavior. Only a small range of behavior can be explained by social learning theory. For instance, a person expresses his behavior and attitude even when there is no visible and appropriate role model in her or his life. Okay, it is clear. But still, in spite of all these limitations, it is a very good theory to learn, to follow, and to understand for all the workers in the field of education, such as it is important for students, it is important for teachers, and even it is important for guardians, because they have to understand that children have a tendency to follow such type of behavior which has an influence over them. So we are damn sure that we try to introduce, we try to showcase only such type of behavior which we are going to trying to wish that students can follow in future. Okay? And in last, thank you. So, I hope that social learning theory is now clear to all my learners. Okay? Done from my side.